Today we're going to talk about using isometric exercises for pain relief. We're going to look at some of the best science-based practices that are currently available. We are about to release our brain-based practitioner's guide to isometrics. So we have been spending thousands of hours, honestly, looking at isometric research, and there's some really amazing stuff that's coming out. Now, we've known for a long time that isometric exercise outperforms other forms of exercise in terms of pain relief. The research is still, though, complicated, so sometimes it looks like it's much better, sometimes it looks like it's a little bit better, but in general, if you ask most practitioners, most scientists will still say, if you're gonna choose a mode of exercise to deal with pain, particularly kind of chronic issues, isometrics are the way to go. Now, I'm gonna give you some specifics about that. Whenever we discuss isometrics and pain, there are a couple different mechanisms we think, all right? The first thing we know is that whenever we're contracting hard, we are going to get what's called a positive nociceptive input, which basically means it's a training stimulus. We know that we're not being injured by it. Whenever we get a positive nociceptive stimulus, it means that we're going to tell the brain, hey, you're under load, but it's safe. So the key takeaway there is if you're going to set up an isometric exercise for someone, they need to feel safe in doing it. All right. It's very possible for a positive exercise to suddenly become a negative exercise if people feel like they're going to be injured. So number one, the setup is important. You have to have good conversations either with yourself, if it's for yourself, or with them. Then we look at the fact that isometric exercise and cardiovascular control are linked within the brainstem. In fact, nuclei that control pain also control our blood pressure and our heart rate. So another reason that we may see a reduction in pain from isometrics is the fact that we're elevating the heart rate, we're elevating blood pressure a little bit, and that can have positive effects on pain. But what that then tells us is we have to be selective in the type of exercise that we choose within the whole universe of isometrics. So I'm just gonna give you some details and a quick drill to follow. Now, before I get into that, if you are new to Z-Health, we are a brain-based education company. I'm Dr. Eric Cobb, if I didn't introduce myself. We have over 12,000 coaches in over 110 countries around the world. Our specialty is bringing neurology and showing you how to blend it with biomechanics and traditional hands-on approaches and exercise approaches to get better, faster results for your clients. So if that is interest to you, make sure to check out all of our free stuff here, subscribe to the channel, and sign up for our mini course. When we're doing isometrics for pain, we have a contraction intensity that should be between 30 and 50%. Most of the research that shows the best results are between 40 and 50. If you're in the 10 to 25, doesn't do much. If you are in the 80 to 100%, so max effort, it also doesn't do very much, probably too threatening. So the sweet spot for isometric contractions for pain relief is 30 to 50% of your maximum. Now, I'm gonna imagine that I have some right trap pain. So what I'm gonna do, I'm setting up, I've got a nice strap here over my shoulder. I'm gonna step on this other strap so I have a little bit of resistance. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna begin an upper trap. I'm gonna shrug, basically. I'm gonna shrug up, and I'm gonna shrug until I feel I'm between a 3 and 5 intensity out of 10. That's gonna be the easiest way to get a client to understand what contraction intensity we wanna use. Now here's the second part. Once you're here, remember, we have the nuclei related to cardiovascular control being impacted, and we know that that also impacts pain inhibition. We need to stay here long enough that those areas become upregulated. Here's what the research shows. If I hold this for 1 minute, I will get some modicum of pain relief. However, if I want to maximize the amount of pain reduction I'm getting from my time spent doing this isometric, I want to aim for around 5 minutes. That's a very, very long time to hold this contraction, so you have to really pay attention. Now, the reason for that is when it's compared minute by minute, a 3-minute isometric is twice as effective for reducing pain as a 1 minute, and a 5-minute isometric is twice as effective as a 3-minute. So if we can last the full 5 minutes, we are gonna get about a 4 times greater reduction in pain than if we just do a 1 minute isometric. So this whole time, I'm holding this around a 3 out of 5, but what I can tell you is I'm starting to feel my heart rate go up just a little bit. If I were to continue doing this, I'm gonna start sweating a little bit. So I can tell that the autonomic control nuclei are getting some stimulation. people should start to get a little hot. They should start to go, well, I'm not out of breath, but I can feel my heart rate going up. Some people will start to sweat. You'll start to see their cheeks getting a little bit red. So we know that they're working. It's not threatening, however, because it actually feels kind of good whenever we have the right exercise. So this is a basic approach to using pain relief isometrics. Remember, 30 to 50% of the maximum, and you want to aim for about a 5-minute hold. Obviously, if they're deconditioned, you're going to have to play with those parameters, but that's kind of the ideal world that we're seeing in the research right now. If you're interested in isometrics for everything under the sun, from blood pressure to strength and hypertrophy and sports and injury prevention, etc., we talk about all that from a current research perspective in the isometrics module, so make sure to check that out when it becomes available. Otherwise, try this. It is really, really remarkably effective for many people. I hope you get a lot out of it.